So apparently, I just did this big long video and it wasn't recording. So I'm going to start all over again. It's not good. You know, Satan is the prince of the power of the air. So if it's anything to do with God, then you know that Satan's going to get involved to try and stop it. So I'm just making this off-the-cuff video. First time I ever made one, just because I got this stupid laptop that I just bought, which I don't even know why, but I guess God has a purpose for me in these end times. Jesus is coming soon. He is coming. He's not coming back as a meek and mild lamb, the perfect lamb of God that he came as the first time he came to this earth, as love. I mean, he is love, but he's coming back the second time to judge. To judge mankind, all those who have denied him will be burned up as stubble. But I won't get into all that yet. I just wanted to make a very quick video to say that Jesus is coming back very soon. The world is carrying on right now. Everything looks fine. It's a beautiful day today. It's September 20th, 2019. It looks like everything's fine, but it's not fine. They've sent warships to the Strait of Hormuz, or whatever you want to call it. Trump, the actor puppet, Masonic Jesuit puppet that he is, that many Christians seem to believe that he's believes in God and is a born again Christian. No, it's all a lie. He's not. He's just doing a job. He was put there for a purpose. Whether and God is allowing it, yes, but he's a wicked king. The people called for a wicked king and they got one. Anyway, that's another whole other video. So the purpose of this video is to say Jesus is coming soon. I don't know how much time we have left. I want everybody to know that Jesus died for your sins. He came the first time, the perfect Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. He walked the earth. He taught. He healed. He cast out demons. He made disciples, and he has commanded us to do the same. So that is what I'm going to do. Whatever he has for me, I'm here. I'm ready. I'm going to do it. I don't know how long I have on this earth. I know there's going to be a rapture. I don't know when it's going to be. We could be here through many trials and tribulation, and we have to be prepared for that. We have to. The only thing we have to do is endure to the end. And what, when, and how that end comes, we don't know. But everybody's got to know that this wicked world, as it is not going to stay this way for long. Everything looks fine on the shiny outside, but underneath, it's festering. It's rotten to the core. And I just wanted to let everyone know that Jesus loves you so much. He loves you so much. Just believe on him. Believe that he is who he says he is, the Son of God. He died for us. He died an excruciating, horrifying death, hung on a tree after being whipped with those cattails, or whatever you call them, that rip into your skin. He probably had hardly any skin left on his body. He was hung on a tree, naked, bleeding, and he did it willingly. He knew it was coming, but he was the perfect Lamb of God. He led a perfect, sinless life. He gave it up as a payment for our sins. The sacrificial system was set up by God. They used to sacrifice the animals, and apparently they're starting that up again this month. In fact, it's even this coming week. They're doing a sacrifice. They've invited 70 nations to Israel. They're going to sacrifice some animals that to get their third temple on the go. But basically, they've got an underground temple. The Sanhedrin meet underground, and it's already there. If the Christians think that they have to build that third temple first before anything happens, as far as the Antichrist going in to sit in the holy place, no, That is just the wicked ones making their own fulfillment of prophecy. We, as believers in Jesus and his sacrifice, we are the temple of God. So I believe the mark of the beast has to do with the Antichrist, because, you know, once we accept this, I mean, that is putting in the evil into the holy place. But I won't even get into it all, because it's hard to understand, and until God gives you revelation yourself, you won't understand it. So all we have to know as people on this earth right now is great judgment is coming. We don't have to live through God's judgment. We don't have to. We can be rescued. God will rescue us. That doesn't mean that we'll be rescued out of our easy chairs. You know, we will go through tribulation. We already are. Just most people don't see it because there's so much deception. You know, they control the weather. They poison us in the air, the food and the water, the vaccines. This whole world is a lie. But anyway, I just wanted everyone to know that Jesus loves you. God, the Father in heaven, loves you more than you will ever know. You'll never understand it until you get to heaven. There will be a new heaven and a new earth, but that's down the road. We have to get through this time. I would just encourage anyone who does not know Jesus to call on his name. Ask him, even if you're in the midst of full-blown sin, whatever you're doing, if you're still doing drugs, it doesn't matter. You ask God to reveal himself to you. Know that you are a sinner. Know that you need a Savior. All it is surrendering yourself. It's humbling yourself and saying, I am a sinner. I cannot save myself. I deserve hell. I deserve death. But Jesus took all that for us. All we have to do is believe in him and what he did. Ask him to reveal himself to you. Jesus, I don't know you. I want to know you. I want to know if you're real. Please show me. Please show me. Forgive me. Repent of your sins, any sins that you know of. Ask him to forgive you. Repentance just means turning away from. And it's hard. It's very hard to do that on your own. So he will do that with you and for you by sending his Holy Spirit. When you repent of your sins and you're baptized in water, which God also has told us to do. Jesus said those who are saved and those who believe and are baptized will be saved. So I believe that baptism in water is a very important part. That doesn't mean that if somebody dies without having been baptized, they won't be saved. I just believe that it's more complicated than we'll understand this side of heaven, but I believe it's important to be baptized in water. So if you don't know Jesus, just ask him to show you. He has appeared directly to so many people, especially Muslims who are entrenched with their culture, and they'll lose their families and everything if they believe. Same with a lot of Jewish people. They believe in Jesus, they'll be ostracized by the family. So ask him to reveal himself to you. Just be humble. Ask him, Jesus, if you're real, please show me. That's what I did. It was about 8 years ago now. I asked him, and he revealed himself to me in a powerful way. Not all at once, but I had a peace come over me where there once was very extreme anger and depression, sadness, anxiety, everything. All those emotions that we get in trying to struggle our way through this world, we think we're the only ones that are going through this, feeling this terrible, suicidal, whatever it may be. So many people are walking around feeling the same way, but nobody's admitting it to each other. But it's a hard, hard world right now, and it is going to get much harder very soon. If you don't know Jesus, if you don't have him, you won't make it through this time. You just won't. If you do find yourself watching this video later and it's obviously tribulation going on, the mark of the beast is going to be pushed on everybody, but you're still going to have to make that choice yourself. The mark of the beast will be a mark, a tattoo on your hand, on your forehead, or a chip. It will be so that you can go to the store and buy food. If you're still here, what the system is going to do is have control over everything. They already do. They already do control this world. We live in a prison. We just don't see the prison bars yet, but we will. There's going to be FEMA camps and all sorts in their efforts to control the people. Many will die before this time, so you don't want to die without Jesus. The mark of the beast, it will be, like I said, a tattoo or a chip. It will change your DNA so that you're no longer human. You're going to be basically mixed with the machine. Welcome to the machine, basically, as Pink Floyd said. AI. AI is, like I'm talking to probably an AI thing right now. These new laptops, they're just listening to every word you say. But I plead the blood of Jesus over this video. I pray that if anyone sees it, and anyone, just one person would see it and call upon the name of Jesus to be saved, then it's all worth it. I hope to do more videos. I don't know how this will go, but I just want to say that Jesus loves you so, so much. And he is our Savior. He's our King. He's our Bridegroom. He's coming back soon. And for those who rejected him, he's coming back in fire and fury and judgment. And you don't want to face that, Jesus. So thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I will talk to you all again. My name is Janice, and I love you all. Bye-bye.